Hello, I'm Ruth Cohen.
Hi, Ruth. We're so glad you're here. Just to start off, how long have you been a member of the society?
I've been a member of this society since I was in college, and I graduated in 1949. You can do the math.
Okay. And you were born in?
I was born here in the United States in 1927.
As a New Yorker?
I'm a native born, but I do travel and have traveled.
And tell us a little bit about your parents.
My father came here as an older teenager and then went to through Columbia Pharmacy. My mother was born here in New Jersey.
Uh-huh.
And my real introduction to the society was listening to the radio, Algernon Black, when we could afford to do that. We no longer can afford to do that. And it was very impressive. And when I did come here, we had such various dates, and I was told so many different things. My husband did not belong with me, but I paid and I came. I came after he died, but I certainly paid all this time. I believed what Algernon Black said. I liked what he said. I say what I think. They said what they think, and I believed it.
What did you particularly like about what Algernon Black said?
Well, there's no one statement. We're living it today, and there's plenty of work to do today.
To make this a better world, is that what you're saying?
Well,
to fix the ills?
That's one of the credo we live to.
Yeah. Deed, not creed.
Tremendous lot of work to do.
Oh, and how? What was your education like?
I went through the public schools of New York City. My mother did not allow me to skip at that time. They allowed that. She allowed my brother to skip. I was not very happy about that. I didn't forgive her for a long time about that. And I went through Queens College.
Uh-huh.
And then when I was married, I have an MBA from Long Island University. I have a degree in speech from Brooklyn College, and then I got my doctorate in art history.
Where did you get that?
Union Institute and University. And that was quite unusual. I was very happy to do that. It made it possible for me to do a very interesting book on art and healing. Probably I should have brought it with me, but I haven't. However, there is one in the library here.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. Tell me, you sort of said it, but how is ethical culture important to you?
Well, if we try to live up to what it says, there is no other way to go. But the most fascinating is to watch people who come here who are new. And when they hear how we think and what we say about issues, and they realize that they've been thinking those things all these years and they didn't believe in them or their own self, I find it so fascinating that they should know that there are other people who think like they do and they discovered. It's as if they discovered America. It is absolutely marvelous, the most wonderful thing. I really love that. They found out they could believe what they believe.
Yeah.
And they didn't understand it. I do find there are issues that are difficult for me, and I'm not so accepting so readily. I have to work on it, but I just can't automatically accept you because you're you. Sometimes I balk.
You're allowed. You're human.
Well, I don't know.
What do you feel the most important thing a person can do with their life?
I never really gave that direct thought. However, I do think that you have to live up to the very best that you are.
Mm-hmm.
I also think that you need to lead by example. Therefore, if you're going to be the best person that you are, you have to be careful that you do the right thing. You have to lead by example.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't know who's watching, and it's important.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And what, in a sense, I guess you're saying it, but what words do you have for young kids these days?
I really don't know. I wonder a lot what the young people think about all this, because the world outside is terribly frightening. Nobody's doing very much to supersede the tribalism that's going on, let alone the barbarism and getting back to the caliphate. And half of them don't understand where all this historical stuff came from. And to watch the destruction of civilization is an astonishment. It's absolutely beyond belief that the kids have to watch that. And I worry, what do they think about that stuff?
You mean the stuff that ISIS is destroying?
Yes, I do.
And the Taliban did so.
Yes,
and
I do. I do mean all of that.
Yeah, I do too. I do too. I think we all do.
Well, I don't know what the young people think. Now, you know, on the, maybe I should go into the speech right now.
Please, go on.
On the AEU, on the website, when they get the news and what's happening, they want to know how to grow the societies and all of those things.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there are two phenomena that just happened. One of them was a 3D printer, and one of them was crowdsourcing, fundraising, and becoming an Encino zillionaire in 2 minutes with ice buckets. And I decided that there has to be something in there that we should be able to apply to make the ethical society grow. Why can't they get their act together? Why doesn't our communications department know that there's crowdsourcing and that's how you do it? You give them a piece of the action and payback time comes.
Out of the mouths of wise people come wise thoughts.
Tell them
we have it.
Tell us when you should turn that off.